Hi. Today we're going to talk about coir or coir, all depending on the way you want to pronounce it. This is a new component that we find in many growing media offered on the market these days. Okay, so where does coir come from? Well, actually, it comes from coconuts. We eat the coconut. That's the inner part here. That's the part that we eat. But all this external shell here can be used for other products. And there's two types of coir products that are mainly used in growing media. You have the hairy part here that's in the middle that has the longer fibers. And then you have the more dense fibers here that we call chunk coir. So these are the fibers and this is the chunk coir. And you might wonder, well, what can it do for a growing media? How can it be useful? Well, it has a lot of really interesting advantages in using coir. The coir, first of all, has a lot of affinity with water. So it'll really wet up fast and help also hold on to some of that water. Also, this chunk coir part here, it'll give a lot of porosity in a mix, so it'll give some airspace there that the roots need to be well developed. And so if you add these proportions to the peat moss, it really makes a great mix for long-term crops that are, you know, more than 5, 6, 7 weeks, baskets, perennials, and even woody ornamentals do really, really good in a coir-based mix. In the first years that coir was marketed, a lot of people found that it would generate a lot of salts and bring up the electrical conductivity in the growing media. Now the industry has come up with ways of washing this coir, so salts are almost not an issue anymore and should not be considered as such. There's really good products available and the salt is no longer an issue. So thank you for listening.
For more information, visit our website, follow us on social media.